Zlodej! Zlodej!
This video is from my friend when he decided to catch a money scammer. Was he successful? But let's not get ahead of ourselves. This is a story of how we got one money scammer in front of the court. This is the story of Billy. All the stories we've shown you so far regarding the money scammers were only small misdemeanors. It was never a felony. Well, except for the raccoon, but he's a special case. We never managed to film a money scammer during an exchange with a tourist where he would exchange more than 400 euros, which is the borderline between a misdemeanor and a serious felony. But my friends were more successful.
This specific video is from the summer of 2020. Not too many tourists were visiting Prague that season, but more importantly for our case, the law that defined a felony was different. Back then, if you scammed someone for 200 euros, it was a felony. Now, the guy on the right is my friend Kuba, and he is just getting 6,000 crowns from the ATM, that's around 450 euros. And the guy on the left, that's giving my friend some looks, is our money scammer Billy. The second my friend has his money, Billy approaches him and offers to break his larger bills into some smaller ones. But instead of Czech crowns, he is about to give him expired Belarusian rubles, and therefore scam him.
Or six if you have it. It'll be awesome. Yeah, 6,000. It'll be awesome. 6,000? Can I count it? Can I count it? This thing?
Six.
This is three, four. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yeah,
Now, just to clarify, I was not present at this situation, and maybe just like you, I was surprised that the money scammer did not notice he was being filmed. He was so focused on the money exchange, he simply didn't pay attention that somebody's filming him from the back. He only noticed when my friends told him they're about to call the cops.
Tak, a půjdete sama na policii, jo? Takže tady se postavíte.
Now, the money scammer was not really into this whole let's wait for the cops game, and he took a run for it.
Thanks to some waiters from the nearby restaurants, they managed to catch Billy at the old town square, and they waited for the cops while Billy was insulting them. The cops took our boy Billy to here, the nearby police station, where his act was classified as a felony. Therefore, they pressed charges against him. Since we had a very clear and strong evidence of the act, the case actually went here to the court in Prague 1.
Zákoník žádám pana státního zástupce, aby přednesl návrh na potrestání. 18.9.2020 byly po 19 hodin zájemce o směnu cizích měn na české koruny, či zájemce o směnu banku na český korun, s čím vše souhlasil, poté přidal 12 kusů bankovek, již neplatných do ruských rublů, předstíral, že se jednalo 12 kusů bankovek, nominální hodnotě 500 korun českých, na češ podezřelý se dal na útěk, však posléze byl zadržen na staroměstském náměstí. Tedy se obohatil tím, že uvozník omyl a způsobil ten necizní majetku škodu nepatrnou.
The state prosecutor suggested the punishment for Billy to be a parole and also a deportation from our country for 5 years. The court was looking at Billy as a special recidivist. He already had 6 criminal records here in our country.
Ohledně vašeho vyjádření proti vyhoštění, proti trestu vyhoštění. Vy jaké máte vztahy k České republice?
Mám dvě děti, které jsou české občany.
Jak dlouho žijete v České republice?
Od 95 let.
Já stále trvám na těch trestech navržených v návrhu na potrestání.
And finally, this was the verdict.
Staňte a poslyšte rozsudek jménem republiky. Obžalovaný je vinen, že dne 18. září 2020 v době kolem 19.10 hodin v Praze 1 choval v okolí bankomatu zájemce o směnu cizích měn na české koruny. Tedy sebe obohatil tím, že uvedl někoho pomyl a způsobil tak na cizí majetku škodu nikoli nepatrnou. A odsuzuje se trestu odnětí svobody v trvání 6 měsíců. Podle paragrafu 81 odstavec 1 a 82 odstavec 1 trestního zákoníku se obžalovanému povoluje podmíněný odklad výkonu trestu a zkušební doba se stanoví na 3 roky.
Finally, Billy was not deported. He got a probation for 3 years, and the state also took away his expired money. The judge did not deport him because he has 2 kids that do live in Bulgaria, but they have Czech citizenship.
Now let's move back from 2020 to today, or more specifically yesterday, when I came back after 2 weeks from vacation, and I was just about to meet Honza at our favorite coffee place. I was walking here on the street, and guess who I saw standing by these ATMs getting ready to scam some tourists? Yep, our boy Billy.
Dobrý den. Dobrý den. Dobrý den. Můžu? Počkáme na policii.
Já jsem s kamarádem tady, nech mě na pokoji. Poslouchej mě, já tady mám strach s kamarádem. Kdo si ty ve? Nech mě na pokoji.
Hej! Já nevím, kdo si ty.
Já jsem okrást ty lidi. Zůstaňte stát. Zavoláme policii a počkáme na
mě.
Chill, chill. Jenom nechci uvoj. Počkáme na policii. Jste ochotný na ně počkat?
Jo? Ty jsi blázen, my co
chceš udělat? Jsem blázen, vy jste zlodí, já jsem radši blázen než zlodí. Počkáme.
At one point, I had to stop the recording of the video on my phone because I needed the phone to call the cops. The minute I turned it off, Billy got really aggressive towards me and started punching me. And not only that, he was also trying to get rid of his wallet that was full of the expired Belarusian rubles. Eventually, 5 minutes later, the cops arrived.
And there was a lot of them. Since Billy was aggressive, more people around me actually called him. They found a stashed wallet full of expired rubles on Billy, but nothing else. So after a short chat at the police station, the cops had to let him go.
But you know, whenever there's a money scammer, there's always a bizarre twist to the story. Well, this time it is that eventually, when we came to the coffee place with Honza to, you know, wrap up things, 20 minutes later, guess who showed up from behind the corner? Our money scammer Billy, and he was heading towards another ATMs to scam more people. But he noticed us, so he turned around and he got lost in the streets of the old town. We lost him, but that doesn't mean we're not gonna find him again. Most likely we will very soon. And you can as well. We're still getting pictures from our viewers whenever they see a money scammer around Prague. So if you happen to see one, take a picture of him, warn other people that he's a scammer, and you can help us and also fellow tourists. We're the Honest Guides from Prague. Our job is to help you on your travels. So I hope after watching this, you will never ever fall into this trap slash scam, and you will enjoy our lovely city. See you next week. And in the end, I always teach a Czech word regarding to the episode you just watched. This time it's going to be how to say if you have a criminal record. In Czech, it's zápis v trestním rejstříku. Criminal record is zápis v trestním rejstříku. And if you happen to be Billy, you now have seven of those. Sedum. Seven.